Listen, I'm into glitter, so we're good. It's the holiday season. Oh my gosh.
So the story behind these, first of all, because you're flying. So these are hand-blown glass ornaments from Mitchell County. By some local artisans in Mitchell County. Which used to be in my district. Mitchell County has the most Republican precinct in the state of North Carolina.
Is that right?
Well, I'm here for Patrick because obviously we stick together as Republicans. He's been serving North Carolina for so long and is really loved in the western part of the state, all over the state, but the western part especially. So I, when he asked if I would come down and speak here, I said absolutely. I'd be more than happy to do it. So I'm here tonight, hopefully to help him raise a little money for his campaign. And you know, it's always important to have good people in Congress supporting the president, and that's something that he's done, and we're excited he gets to continue to do.
What are some of the topics you're going to speak about tonight?
Well, the president will certainly come up. You know, it's a family affair. The whole thing since day one has been a family affair with my father-in-law, and that's why I'm here today. That's why I'm at the campaign. That's why I get to go around and speak at different events for congressional members, senators, governors all over the country. And in my home state, obviously, I'll talk about that. I'm from North Carolina. I was born and raised in Wilmington. And you know, we'll have a good time. See what everybody feels like talking about. Maybe somebody will throw me questions. I don't know. You never know. We'll see where the night takes us.
And the reason why I wanted Laura here is because she's a North Carolinian. She's the North Carolina connection to the Trump family. NC State grad,
yes.
Which is good for me. and has been an articulate spokesman for the cause. And it's something else. She's really volunteering her time in an incredible way for the president, for the Republican National Convention that we're hosting here in Charlotte. Mm-hmm. And we were together about a month ago,
yeah.
When we 2 months ago when we announced the date for mm-hmm. the convention. And so and we're gonna see a lot more of her. And so I wanted to make sure that folks from my district got to see her before she takes such a prominent role going into the convention in 2 years. So we've got folks coming from around the state to be here in Gastonia, and it's a really special thing.
Both yourself and the president have had experience of 64% of President Trump in 2016 had 64% of the vote in Gaston County. You had 64% of the vote as well in 2018. So you have a lot of support here in Gaston County for both of your campaigns. How do you?
If I was with the president, he would tell me how much better or worse that I did in Gaston County, right?
he gets
deeply into the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, I mean, look, Gaston County's been a strong supporter of conservative causes. But the president's brand that he ran on in the last election, strong on regulatory reform, tax cuts, and speaking to the trade issues that have devastated Western North Carolina in a way that very few Republicans speak. Those are great things for Gaston County and Western North Carolina. That trade message is very similar to what I've been talking about for quite a while. Now, obviously, he does it better than I do in terms of the messaging, but it is a helpful thing when you have somebody who's willing to fight for the economic causes that we desperately need in Gaston County. And that's why the president did so well in Western North Carolina.
Mark, for the 2020 campaign, for President Trump's 2020 campaign, how do you ensure that you receive a vote from his supporters who voted for him in the 2016 election?
Well, I think all we have to do is look to the president, look to what he's doing for the country. I mean, people always ask, what is our strategy for 2020? The strategy is happening right now. We see it every day. We've seen it in less than 2 years of this president being in office, the fact that we have the lowest unemployment numbers we have ever seen in this country, the fact that manufacturing is coming back to this country, that people have jobs for the first time in, you know, decades in some cases. The president is his own best salesperson, as it turns out, for the campaign in 2020. He's gonna do all the work ahead of time, and I really think there will be a lot of people. Listen, I have no doubt the people that voted for him in 2016 will come back to vote for him, but I think there will be a lot of folks that didn't vote for him in 2016 who have seen what he can do, and with a lot against him, what he can do. I think they're going to come out and vote for him in 2020.